to kind of wrap things up a little bit here, what morsels of advice or what kind of advice can you offer to aspiring writers? Like right now, today, what can they do to help their career?
Yeah, there's kind of two suggestions. One is for writers that haven't gotten into the business yet, haven't broken in, and the other are for writers that are actually working. If you're a writer and you're trying to break into the business, I think it's important. You've got to be like an octopus. You need to have opportunities everywhere, and part of that comes from that old adage: it's who you know. And you'll never know who. You make a friend or a college friend and they know somebody and they're talking and oh, they can hand somebody a script. I've actually hired writers. I hired one writer who was a friend of my ex-fiance, and my ex-fiance said, hey, I know you're doing this show. I know this great writer. And I said, all right, I'll take a look. And I, you know, as a favor, I looked at it and I said, hey, this is pretty good. I met with the person and they got hired that way. Another person I knew is I had worked with on Smallville, the script coordinator who I briefly interacted with on Smallville. He was a really good guy. When it was announced that I got Spartacus, that I was doing Spartacus, he boldly sent me an email saying, "Hey, congratulations! It's really great. Listen, I know this is a lot to ask, but my brother and I are writers, and you know, if you would take a look at our scripts." And again, I'm like, all right. And I read it, and I not only loved their spec script, I hired them on the show and optioned their script to try to get up and running. So it's a combination of really networking, so you have these opportunities. It's also a good bit of luck, and even more importantly, it's when the opportunity presents itself to be prepared, to have that bit of material. So the big thing for writers that haven't broken in yet is you have to write constantly. When I was, like I said, I spent 6.5 years as an English teacher in the Valley. And, you know, so my first professional break happened at about 33, which was a little older than I thought it would be. But during those 6.5 years, you know, at least 5 days a week, I was writing something. And a lot of times, you know, I would write I've got a stack of spec features in a drawer that no one will ever see. Because a lot of it was, you know, I look back and it's like, that's terrible, that has a little bit of promise, but you really just got to keep doing it and practicing. And if you're trying to break in, enter as many contests as you can. I got my first real agent by being a finalist in the Nicole Fellowship. So every year I would enter and enter and enter. And, you know, it really does help. If you're actually already a working writer in the business, you know, again, it's like we were talking about earlier, your personality has as much to do with it, especially when I'm putting together a staff. And I take this from Joss Whedon. Joss always said, you can be the best writer in the world. If you don't get along with the family, I don't want you on the staff. So I've read scripts that I thought were quite good. And then you sit down and meet with the person and it's like you just blew it in the interview. Because you have to remember that these are people you're going to spend 8, 10, 12 hours a day with in a room. And I don't want to spend my time in a room with somebody that agitates me or agitates the other people who are trying to do their job. So you need to be the kind of person that people want to be around. Now look, there are plenty of assholes that have made it in this business and have risen to the top. But I think that's the exception and not the rule. And another a friend of mine who gave a great piece of advice of writing is that everybody at some point, I've been lucky because this hasn't happened to me, but usually everybody coming up at some point has a showrunner or somebody above them who is abusive and not a great person. But you have to break that cycle that you should not be that person. Because the best way to get great work from your writers is to inspire them and to have them want to do well. And
that just sounds like that's what you do. I mean, especially from the panel, all of your writers were just...
That's absolutely what I try to do. I mean, first and foremost, for me, I always go into it, I want to have a good time. I like having fun in the writer's room. When you're an executive producer, showrunner, there's so much of the other bit of the process that's not fun. I've always said the only two purely creative places when you're running a show. It's the writer's room and when you're in editing. Everything else, it's a compromise, it's doing this, it's doing that, it's dealing with various, you know, you always, by necessity, when you get 12 people in a room, nobody's going to agree on something.
Which is why the team player.
Yeah, but those two places are my favorite places to be. That and behind the camera directing, but that's a whole nother pressure cooker. But yeah, I mean, the biggest thing is you know, you really need to be passionate about your work, and you really need to get along with others, because if you don't, you certainly could rise up. But the other big secret that a lot of people don't realize is showrunners talk to each other all the time. Whenever staffing season comes along, I get multiple calls, and I will call other showrunners to say, hey, I see this person worked with you, you know, give me the download. And for a while there was a period early on where showrunners would not say anything bad about anybody. And I know, I it happened to me. I hired somebody because they got a glowing, you know, review. And then after I had to let that person go, a year later, I talked to somebody that had been on that show, and I said, yeah, what's up with that? And he said, oh, exact same problem on our show. I'm surprised they got a good recommendation. But, you know, nobody wants to be the bad guy and say, look, this is the issues. But nowadays, I think showrunners, because it's such an intense thing that you have to do, they're more willing to, you know, very privately give you the pluses and the minuses. And I always give the pluses and minuses, not just the minuses, and let the person decide for themselves. But I can tell you, I know that talking to other showrunners, there were people that up for a job that did not get it because of their behavior on a show. You can't just have bad behavior on a show and expect you'll go to the next one and nobody will know, because we do talk to each other. Because it's so important to have that group together. So basically, don't be an asshole.
Exactly.
Work hard, don't be an asshole.
It all comes back to that. So, I mean, I think we should just end it with that, because that's pretty epic advice.
There you go.
Thank you again so much for your
time.
My
pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
With Scripts and Scribes.